Nueva modificación. La placa ya se está quebrando. Luego no me digan que se pierde, ni que se rompe, ni que no sé qué. Se va a poner en vertical para poder agarrar de cuatro puntos. En la parte de atrás.
Espación.
Tengo arandelas, si quieres. Me sobraron de la desbaratation.
Que empiece a empezar de arriba o...
¿Cómo gustas?
No, no, son muy pequeñas. Digo, son muy grandes.
No sé cómo se ve así, creo.
Así, ¿verdad?
Aluminio a las 24 horas del día, háblale. Y más con una ballena. Listo, 4 minutos y medio, tiempo récord, ya quedó la placa y espero que ahora sí no se pierda. Muchísimas gracias, pero por desgracia, sin uso excesivo se está rompiendo.
Even before construction was completed, people observed its peculiar behavior. That was because, even in a light breeze, ripples ran along the bridge. After a while, one of the local humorists called her Galloping Gertie. And for fairly obvious reasons, the name stuck, at least until the 7th of November, 1940. Then as now, Seattle and Tacoma were sports-minded cities. For 4 months, a regional sport was to drive across the bridge on a windy day. While some claimed it was like riding a roller coaster, others found it a little disconcerting to see the car in front disappear. How popular this bridge sport was, or to what extent it might have spread across the country, is anybody's guess. On November 7, 1940, the winds were relatively moderate, about 40 miles per hour. A new mode appeared. Rather than ripple, the bridge began to twist. A wind of 40 miles per hour is not too strong, but it was strong enough to start the bridge twisting violently. And at 11 a.m., it fell. Investigators were mystified. Bridge constructed according to the best engineering standards of the day, perhaps the best bridge in the world. This was not a bridge that was supposed to collapse. What in the world had happened? Theodore von Karman, a Caltech professor and a pioneer in modern aerodynamics, came forth with the answer. Von Karman's explanation of vortex shedding. and resonant oscillations was not universally popular among construction engineers. However, as verified by wind tunnel tests at Caltech and at the University of Washington, von Karman's